Hi guys, welcome to BLC online course, and this video is all about the concepts of NO and NC inside the PLC. You know that many times we use NC switches to stop the process. You know, NC are typically used to stop the process. But in case if you don't have NC switch in your PLC inputs, you have NO switches to stop the process. Is that a possible? Yes, it is, because you know inside the PLC we can take NO and NC contacts of these relays. Now, if you remember, I have told you in the other videos that assume these contacts IN0, 1, 2, 3 up to 7 or X0 up to 7 as relays, and these are the switches which are actuating these relays. So now I'll clear the confusion of NO and NC by this small logic, which says that this is my IN0, it is turning on the output OUT0, this one, this is the OUT0, and this is the contact of this coil. So this is a latching example. So let's see, if I press IN0, this output is latched. So here it is latched, you can see that output is on. Now I want to stop this latching, I want to unlatch this circuit using NO switches, using this switch, how that can be done. So now you can see that this switch is used to actuate IN1. So to turn off this contact, to turn off this output coil, I have to introduce NC of this IN1. Okay, so let's see what will happen. Let me connect that. So this comes here, and this will go here, and I'll give it a tag of IN1 like this. Okay, so now you see that IN1 is off, this relay is off. So that's why its NC contact is closed. Okay, this is the NC contact, this is not NC switch. Switch is NO, you know, there's a difference between switch and contact. This is NC switch, sorry, this is NO switch, this is NC switch, this is NO contact, this is NC contact. Contacts are typically which are, you know, either inside a PLC or which are inside the relay. The contacts are those typically which are turned on and off by electromagnetic action or softer modes. NC switch is a physical switch, NO or NC switch. This is a physical switch, and these are the auxiliary contacts. Alright, so what will happen if I press this X0? This output is latched because this is normally closed. So when I turn on IN1 by again NO, this will get open, because this relay get on and this will get open. So like this, output will be unlatched. I'll try again, this will be latched and this will be unlatched. So now I hope this makes sense. Now I want that this stop operation should be done by this NC switch, alright, X2. So for that, if I take IN1, let's take this NC switch, NC contact, let me rename it to IN2. Let's let it be like NC, alright, so that you can understand well. Now this is open because this is already on. This is NC contact, NC switch, which is turning on the relay, and this contact is on. Now in this case, I cannot turn on the output because this is already open. So in case if you are using NC switch to stop the process, you have to take NO contact inside, because this relay is already on. So NO contact will be already closed. So we can see next here again. Let's take an NO contact and let's name it as IN2. Now I hope this will be clear. Now you can see that this is closed. This indicates this is closed. Now because this is closed, because this X2 has turned on this IN2. If I press this, that will be open. So now I can latch the output using metal. Okay. To unlatch it, I have to open this. This will be open when this relay gets off, because this NO contact which get open when relay gets off. So this will be open. So the latching, unlatching is, you know, that can be done using NO contact or NO switch or NC switch. It depends. If you're using NO outside to stop the process, you have to take NC inside. If you're taking NC switch outside to stop the output, you have to take NO contact inside. That is a small misconception which often occurs, because sometimes if you are taking NO outside, if we take NO inside also, then this will not work. Alright, so just to clear this concept again, what I'll do is I'll start an output using this button switch, and I'll stop by this, and I'll start again by this, and I'll stop by this. So that will make sense. So this is IN0, I have to take here NC, NC of IN 1. Alright, now in this program, you can see that this is latched, this is unlatched. Now how it is possible to start the process using X2? Okay, so for that we will take an NC here. Let's name it at IN2, and I'll take an output coil here. Let's name it as out 1. And now let's just see this program. In this case, when I press this NC button, output will be on. Okay, because this is already on, so this is open. So this will get closed when this IN2 get de-energized. So I'm using this NC switch as NO operation to start the operation, right? This can be done. As you can see, when I press this NC switch, this output will be on. Okay, just because I have taken this NC inside. Now to latch this again, I have to take, let's copy paste that, out one here, and this will latch this out. So let's try again. So now when I press this is latched out one. Now to unlatch that, I have to use this button, and for that what I'll be using, NO. Okay, NO contact. So let's take another contact, NO, and I'm just giving the address of IN3. Alright, so now see, I hope this operation is clear. By pressing this button, this is latched and this will unlatch the circuit. Now in this operation, I have to take NC here because this is already on. So when I press this button, output is latched. When I press this, so it doesn't matter which switches you have in a PLC, otherwise it will be very complex. If you are using this you want this operation without PLC, it will be very complex. You have to use multiple relays. But if you are using PLC, that software, that letter diagram make it very easy for you. Just we need to understand NO and NC concepts and where to use NO, where to use NC. So by assuming these as relays, I hope this concept will make sense. So that was all. If you have any query related to NO and NC, let me know and drop down a message. I'll either post a video or I'll write down the feedback so that you can clearly understand. Thank you.